Hey guys, in this video we'll see how we can integrate notifications in React. So this is a React web application and this is running locally on local. We now go to Firebase console and inside the console we go to the tab cloud message. We enter the notification title as notification text and text as hello React. Let's click on send test message now. So this is our FCM token which we get from the localhost React app, and let's click on test. We go back to the Hello React app and we see here the notification has arrived. So this was in the foreground. Now let's see what happens when this app is in the background. We again navigate to the Firebase console and let's click on send test message. But this time our app would be in background. And you can see here the notification has arrived. We need to configure our project. So just go to Firebase console and under the general tab, navigate to the your app section and take a note of the config for your web app. Next, go to the cloud messaging tab and scroll at the bottom. Take a note of your key pair under the web configuration. We install Firebase in our React app using the command. Next, we instantiate a file called as firebase-init.js inside our src folder. So here you can see the Firebase config which we got from the Firebase console. Next, we initialize Firebase in our app using this configuration. Also instantiate the messaging SDK using the import here, and we take a variable messaging. For asking permissions in the web browser, we make use of the method getToken. So this getToken takes in a key called as vapid key, and this is basically our web server push key which we got from the cloud messaging tab. The key looks something like this and is stored in an environment file. This getToken method takes care of if the permission is granted or not, so it's automatically handled by the Firebase SDK for us. We also implement the onMessage, which is responsible when the push message is received and the web app is currently active in the foreground. Now we will take care of how the messages will receive when our app is in background. We will use this file called as Firebase Messaging Service Worker. We import the files for Firebase app and Firebase Messaging JS. Next, we copy paste the Firebase configuration which we get from the Firebase console. We initialize the Firebase inside our app using the configuration above. Next, we instantiate the messaging SDK again in the Service Worker, and this is done by this import statement here. Finally, we implement the on background message handler. This handler receives the payload, and that payload comprises of a JavaScript object. We extract the notification title and notification body from that payload. And finally, we use it to show the notification by passing these two variables. We create our own custom notification component. And inside this component, we import the Firebase init.js. So we call the getToken function, which basically helps us in getting the token. And once we get the token, we console it and so that this can be used for testing out the FCM messages. This is the token which we got from the FCM SDK, and the same token is passed to the notification. The next component we create is a custom React notification component, and this component will basically be called when our application is in foreground. This component makes use of a library called as react-toastify, and we pass in the title and body to be displayed, and finally it gets displayed using the toast container. Inside our app.js, we first import the Firebase init.js. And from here, we implement the onMessage listener, which is basically this So this onMessageListener is invoked whenever we receive a message, and based on the message we use the useState hooks to display the show and hide state of the notification. Next, we import our custom components which we created earlier, and based on the show and hide status of the React notification component, if the app is in foreground, we show it, otherwise we don't. We always call the notifications component since this is responsible for asking the token and consoling it on the browser, whereas the React notification component is only shown when we have received the message and the app is in foreground. That's it from this video, guys. Source code and article links are mentioned in the description below. And thanks, guys, for watching.